Quickstart Armature Animation. At object level, the animation works like for any other object. The pose mode works in general the same. But we have some neat things here that you don't have at object level, like a pose library, or that you can set up an IK rig, or that we can copy and paste poses. First things first, we have most probably bent our poor armature in a wrong pose for weight painting. We need to reset this. Let's select all, go to Pose, Clear Transform, All. Now our pose is reset. Let's switch to Animation Layout. It makes more sense here. The first thing is we need a keying set. For objects you usually use logrod scale. For characters I would suggest to use whole character. Let's record the first keyframe. This is this key here. Now let's say we go to frame 20 and change our pose and record it again. Here in the Dope Sheet Editor you can now see the keyframes that are created. And when we hit the play button, and when we hit the play button, then you can see how the skeleton deforms. And that's basically it. Pose it, then record a keyframe. Sometimes the skeleton is in the way to judge the pose. In this case, you can simply hide it in the outliner. Another important functionality can be found in the key menu, the interpolation mode. This defines how the animation will interpolate. If, for example, a cube goes in linear speed from A to B, or starts slow at the beginning and goes faster. Now let's have a look at the pose library. This can be found here, pose library. Let's select all ones and add our first pose. Add new. You will see here the last operator panel, frame 1, and let's say the name is start pose. Let's do the same for the end pose. You can also add and modify here in the Data tab, in the Pose Library panel. We wanted to add another pose, so let's click at the plus button here, Add New from Current Frame. Let's rename this here to End Pose. Now let's go somewhere in the middle and pose it to completely elsewhere. Here we are. This is what I wanted to do. And again, we add a pose from current frame. Let's say we call it Go Crazy. We haven't recorded a keyframe here, so when we move the slider, the pose is gone. But we have recorded it here. What we have to do now is to click this magnifying glass here, apply pose, library pose, and then we can keyframe it. You can now use this pose everywhere where you need it.